Hey guys, how's it going? Today is Borderlands 3, start of the new boss week, so that each boss will drop a special weapon, and we are here with Bizarre over here, Bizarre Game, and I think we decided to go after Pain and Terror. They will be dropping the legendary class mods, so we are going to go ahead and grind him out. We are on Vault Mayhem 3. And it makes it super difficult to... Let's see what we got. The Siren class mod. But yeah, it's super difficult. I've been trying to grind it out to see if I can get anything. I ended up getting a grenade from Troy. And I think this is the fire rainstorm, so we're gonna go ahead and equip that. And we are on a little bit early tonight. All right, let's head on out to Pain and Terror. I almost beat him on Mayhem 1, but I couldn't beat him on Mayhem 3. He was whooping on me. So I brought it down to Mayhem 1, and I almost had him. And then, like, I get him down to the very little bit, and then he does this, like, super attack and whoops on me. Go ahead, try again. Hopefully he's not doing it at the same time as me. But we'll be going to Pandora, Guts and Cornovia. Can't even say that. And then these guys are like super difficult. Man, I hate this fast travel. Sometimes I like it, and then other times I really hate it.
Just as good as that asshole. Why didn't they pick me?
I wish it would like send a signal to either myself or him that the fast travel is trying to occur. Because that's the thing that drives me nuts.
Mind over matter. That's what matters.
There we go. We are on our way. So when I tried this on Mayhem 3, I ended up having to run through all these guys just because I have no skills. I don't know if you... I mean, I'm getting like one shot on these guys. These guys are one shot in me. And then they make all of each character like even weaker. They take out like the good grenade. They take out like the update for today is Maz's grenades won't replenish. So I guess you, because there's a way that you can have unlimited grenades and not anymore. I don't think I had that build. But like these enemies here got like unlimited ammo and they don't have to reload. I mean, I know this is Mayhem 3, but still. Screw it. I'm just gonna go. Because our main focus is gonna be the Pain and Terror guy. So I do not even care about these guys. And then they got like the rocket launchers and they literally can spam the rocket launcher crazy. And it's like, why can't we have that? Alright, let's see. And then these little tinks are little biatches. They tear me up too. And then especially the guy that's up on this one. I can't get by him, so I gotta take the other shortcut way. Which is jump on this air vent. We are going to be the mech, so I can get through this really easy. There we go. We got to the next save point.
I spy with my little eye.
Stop him! Then there's a girl that comes out of here that has like a shock damage. Tears me up too. Good. I'm glad I got through that. Not too bad. So far it's going well. Oh, come on. Come on. Run now. As you can tell, I ran through this part already a few times. So I kind of know which way to go. There's going to be an elevator here. I'm not even sure what any of these symbols mean, but I just know that that one goes to Pain and Terror. All right, we are here. Let me go ahead. Message Bazaar. Boss. There we go.
Make a move, Vault Thief! Viewers, comment in the stream and tell us how you want the Vault Thief to die! We got bomb raiders.
So I'm not sure of the exact strategy. I just go for these little red tanks.
And
try to take them out. Watch out for his knife. His knife usually destroys me. Like, these saw blades are really nothing.
With a tenderizer!
A tenderizer. Just gotta slide out of the way.
Let me hear you scream!
I'll try to stay away from Bazaar so we can be on different sides. These challenges are kind of easier with two people. When I only have the one person, or just myself, Like, I die and then there's nothing I can do other than just die and then restart again. Gotta get his nuts. Where's he? He's still on the side. Then now he has this saw blade that goes in circular motion. Oh, watch out. Oh, don't want to go that way. Stay on opposite sides.
I want to see those teeth!
See, and then I get one shot. That's like pisses me off.
What kind of show do you think this is?
I'm invincible! I mean, I got like 10,000 shield, and then I don't have that much health. But still, I shouldn't be getting one shot. $16,500. Nice, he's focused on him. Let's see if I can get his armpit hairs. No! It's like I didn't even get hit by that thing. And still one shot. I'm down to one third of his life, two thirds of his life.
Here's a fan favorite.
And all the video I was watching just before I started playing, they said, like, this guy in Katagawa Jr. is like the easiest guys. Like, no way. No way. And I see these guys just melting them. See, it's like I automatically die just from that fire.
Just like that. Nice and nice.
Is this death number 5? Now I'm not sure where to shoot when all his stuff are gone. What did I get hit from there? Nothing. Check Bazaar in just a second. It's probably telling me how to do it, where to hit.
Look out below!
Maybe gotta take out his front because that's where he's shooting.
sharp, Vault Thief.
Yeah, they did nerf, like, all the characters. Flak's gotten weaker, I forget how. Maz's grenades don't back regenerate as fast.
Smash, smash.
See, it's like, what did I get hit from there? I don't understand. Because I really didn't get hit by the knife until I died, and then he hit me with the knife.
Witness the Agonizer 9000! Our vault thief is on fire! Again. They're about to be. Here's a fan favorite! A big giant knife!
Get over here, dickweed!
Make some noise, you filthy animals!
Terror on him. Oh, look at that.
Just like that.
Our grenades are coming back. Just jump in and throwing grenades.
By popular demand, it's the Mega Blender!
Slide. Then he does this little... When's he gonna drop it? Not again. Ah! Oh yeah. Found the trick.
Time for a quick commercial break. Our ammunition call today is Marcus Munition.
Very nice. I like that.
Hey pal! I'll
new favorite
money,
grenade.
That's just unprofessional.
We survive.
All eyes on you, Vault
Thief! Come on, Bizarre.
We're gonna need a mop.
Is Oh, both of us didn't survive.
Well, that was deeply unpleasant.
Yeah, let's see if I can... I don't have it on the list of what happened. Do you want to change it? We can head back to Sanctuary. I'm okay with those grenades. Those grenades are pretty good. Oh, wow. Do you want to go change? If you want to go attack him, we can go. And I'm just looking up the new fixes. And so I go on this part of the Facebook group, Borderlands 3 Shift Codes. And so they have the notes and everything in there. So Flak, the rack attack status effect chance has been increased to 100%. Leave no trace. Now has a re-trigger delay of 2 seconds. Barbaric Yawp. Stat bonus increased by 100%. Pet no longer push around player characters. Touch pet prompt is now a lower priority and should not. That doesn't really even say anything. But I heard that it was nerfed for Flak. And Maz, Infinite Grenades is not an intentional build for Maz. Even if it's hilarious to lower the power and spam of the build, a re-trigger delay has been added to the grenade portion of the means of destruction. So now there's a 2 second delay for that. But then it's alright if they, you know, make all the other characters like super stronger. They should have just left it and... That's how they brought out the game. They should have kept it the same. Let us have that grenade that dominates if you guys want to make the character stronger. So, I mean, they need to, like, put, like, some ammo and reload stuff for some of these characters. I do want to change out, I think, my pistol. Because I don't like my pistol. See, I don't like that one shot. And... fire damage. I would like probably a corrosive so I can have something different. Pistol. Hopefully I have a corrosive pistol. Here's a shock. I got ice pistols. 49% accuracy, 79-70. Consumes 3 ammos per shot. Oh, that's the Queen's Call. Kind of don't like that gun now that it's got nerfed. Probably going to try that gun out. We will see. So let's change that out. And then we'll put the gun that I have, the Trick Unforgiven, into the vault. And any other weapons that I do not need. Trick Unforgiven, I don't want. I do want to try out this shotgun. It looks pretty strong. sell some guns. If I have enough money, which I doubt I do, then I will go buy an upgrade. Speed loading Hellwalker. Gotta try that one out.
Ah, splendid.
Your business is always appreciated.
Let me go ahead and throw him his class mod back. Dang, has it already been 30 minutes? We still haven't beat him yet?
Hey, pick me up a new chain while you're out there.
See, we almost had him that time with my little grenade thing. Let me actually see if I can buy 280,000. I don't think I have money for anything.
SDU stands for super duper.
There we go. Grenade launchers. I think I could actually buy a second set.
They're supposed to give you the human experience.
Just because I'm gonna lose a lot of money. I also have this other shotgun from the other Borderlands that I used to love. Was it this one? Maybe I put it away. Gotta go check. Conference call. This gun was the shit. Horse face. Then he got a claw foot.
Bing.
How's it going, Bazaar? Ready to beat Pain and Terror. I've been trying to beat him since I think I jumped on just playing around 6:37. And then I got back onto the stream. I started the stream at 8, but I had to prepare for everything. That took like 15-20 minutes to do. So I've been on Pain and Terror for over an hour now.
Thank you.
Hopefully this build's pretty good. I am happy with that. Those grenades. Flak is Garbo now, and Graveward drops more class mods, and he's easy to kill. Okay, if you want to go over to Graveward. And then Graveward is, let me go ahead, bring out my photo. Graveward gives out the earworm. I forget what that one is. I think it's a submachine gun with a really good fire rate.
I have need of you, Beast.
And I kind of suck on Graveward. I hate this guy. He's another guy that one-shots me. Certainly not by me. Nothing. Are we going to go in the vault? Hey, Grant, how's it going? I am going to change up from... cooperation to... or... whatever. They're both the same word. Continue. Then gotta send invite. I like your line, Grant. That's pretty slick. The pumpkin spice is pretty good. Very nice. Good luck. Do you know who Hayden's gonna ask? I'm just wondering. Just because I found out a secret yesterday. That's right, I should go for love. Melts. Wait, way better than last night. But I don't know if that's me or if it's bizarre. It's when I was playing with spiders last night. It was doing nothing like this. Fell down. I think some girl from Rosa because he talks a lot about them. Okay. I heard something about Fiona and Peyton. That's the only reason why I was wondering. Hayden talk a lot. Oh, dang. Look at that. Four of them. Okay, I'm glad that we came to Graveward. We got the hot drop commander planetoid. Rerouter. When fully charged, the next shot drains 50% shield to deal 120 bonus. Radiation stone. All right, ready. Start and restart. Oh yeah. Well, he's got a new girl to like now. No, I just want him to talk to her and to say hi, basically. Because you know how, like, girls are. They want to keep it a secret and they really don't want to tell you that they have a crush on you, and it's stupid. So, like, I make it a point. Like, if I know that a girl likes, like, one of you guys, I will go and tell you guys. Because I would always go, I mean, not that I wanted to hook up with the girl, but if I knew that she liked me, I would go talk to her because it kind of makes their day. And it's just like when a girl walks by and flicks her hair in front of you and then you get all googly eyes, it's like the same thing of just acknowledging the girl and saying hi to her and just asking her how her day was. And then you get into the game of, now she's going to talk to her other friends, and her other friends are going to be liking you too, and then you might be able to get one of her friends that you really do like. They are so secretive, yeah. You got to make the moves. Well, it's hard to make the moves because then it's like, does she really like you? And, I mean, if they don't, then it's kind of, you know, stupid. Wrong one. And then that's when your confidence goes down, when you go try to talk to a girl and they really don't want to talk to you. And then you lose complete confidence. It's like better to just go talk to somebody that you actually, that likes you, even if it's just for a conversation, and to become friends. Yeah, that's not coming for me. I'm doing, like, no damage on this guy. What happened to all the damage that we were doing on him? We were melting him on like the first two. No, fell off. Side.
I'm better than this.
I like that he'll repeat when we went straight up the dam. Yeah, that's a tough little hill repeat that you guys did. From you're already running.
Well, that sucks.
Almost 400 meters. And then you get a little bit of recovery.
Quiet, stay still.
And then you get whatever. 100 meter recovery, and then you're back up on the big ass hill. But it'll prepare you guys for, like, Piner. Piner's gonna be tough. Maybe it was this gun that was the reason why I was melting them. I doubt it. No, I'm doing nothing to him. What's up, Dylan? How's it going? Good to see you on the stream today. How was your workout? What was melting this guy? Because I feel like the first two we were on easy mode, and then now it's like back to piss me off again mode, where I just keep dying. Quick. Damn.
Is that all you got?
Oh, okay. That's what's going on. You're doing all the melting. Give me a sec. We'll wait for a sec. Dang. Back to one shots. I either need to change my build up, which I did last night.
We know you have a choice when it comes to guns.
Or I need to go to more gun damage. Grenades are doing nothing. Just dodge that one. There we go. I had nothing to do with it. We got three more legendaries. Double penetrating devastator. The trooper shield. Probably should start collecting some of these and start selling them. Right, restarting. What gun are you using? Fire Luda. So I think I have a Luda. But then again, I really don't know what is a good gun. So I gotta check that out when I get back to Sanctuary. We do have some points we can spend. Fire rate. Even though I should have done. So I'm gonna give it to you, or you're gonna level up my Zane. I'm not strong enough to beat him myself. Or will I be able to beat him? If I could beat him with this gun, then yeah. I'll level up your Zane. Yeah, I want to say I have this gun. Because it was a sniper rifle. Alright, let's see. Go get some ammo.
No refund.
How am I getting one shot from this guy? Shoot his chest. So I'm gonna, yep. I don't know what was hitting me. Was it like a ricochet off of the guy?
Back to the fight.
See, what am I getting hit by? There's nobody around me. Don't understand, Captain.
Stitched, thanks.
Like I'm getting one shot by nothing, either by the ricochets off the stupid guy. And like, what did I get hit by there? This game. Yeah, I keep getting one shot by nothing. It's either by the ricochet. Yeah.
Yeah.
Nothing. Already own. Already own. Go ahead and reset. I think I just gotta not be all wild. Because those ricochets hurt. Where's your chest? Hopefully you stayed alive. One Rebel Yell. Still haven't got the earworm yet. ...18% weapon critical damage. I do need a better class mon for sure. Right. Quit and restart. I think I'll go probably another half an hour on this, so don't be scared to shoot the gun. I keep getting one shot if I don't aim it. Like the ricochet kills me instantly. Because that's what happened the first time that when we went in and I was just shooting it crazy. I kept getting the one shot on myself. Do I have a better shield? Since I'm already getting one shot. Yeah, I don't know what's going on. Right there, ricochet, dead. So it's like I kind of gotta stay back. Dead again. Dead again. It's ridiculous. Another. Can't tell, I'm annoyed. Because, I mean, you shouldn't be getting one-shot by your own weapon. Damn. Oh, your game crashed? Really need to level up my guy. Get more gun damage. Not sure what like the max stuff is. Add 10% gun damage to all shots while fighting for your life. So I need 15 tokens. Wonder if there's a way to see. Doesn't it give us better XP and stuff for the mayhem? Yeah, what I was looking at is normally it tells you what guardian, how to level up each one to get more guardian tokens, and I don't see that anywhere. Unless there's something in here. Hmm.
on, back up with you.
Appreciate the help, friend.
Gotta be careful. Oh, knocked me out. I guess we're gonna go change it up. I probably only got 15 more minutes in this. So give me a sec, I'll go ahead, fast travel out. What should I put it on, Mayhem 1? But I hate fighting Graveward and just in general. He pisses me off. Like everything one-shots me. But I mean, that's how all the bosses are. See. So I think this is just a weaker version of the gun. Gonna quit. Cooperation. I actually don't remember where he was at. Eden 6. There we go. Floating 2. Yeah, you can take the sniper back. I think we should be able to melt him without me having that sniper, so I'll hook you back up. Because this gun's pissing me off. The one shot coming back at me. No ricochets on one hit, one shots. Much easier. No legendaries. Already owned. ready? Oh, okay. Only Ricochet's in Mayhem 3. That sucks. Because, yeah, if I wasn't accurate at all, which I'm not, that was taking me out quick style.
Now get out of here.
How much XP did you get on that? Did you see? Hopefully enough. I do like this machine gun. Oh. No. You kidding me? Where's all the enemies at?
Death is for poor people.
Oh, we both died. Way better. Rad Pulibus, Venomous Barrage. Any ones you want? Let me know if there's any of those guns that you want. You can pick them up. How much XP are you getting per each one of these? Or that last one? Actually, I want to get rid of those heads first. Up half, very nice. And that one was super easy. No problem with that one. Damn it. At least we got the kill. Hopefully all the loot will still be there. Those stupid acid balls. Another one shot. Well, it's not really a one shot. It hits me and then it's like six shots later. I'm down.
Back to the fight.
Storm and Sickle. What level are you now, Bizarre? I haven't seen. Hopefully we can get you up a few levels. All right. Oh, gotta send the invite and get ammo. Maybe one of these turns I will actually remember what buttons to push.
May they bring you.
Bizarre was in here. I wasn't expecting to kill him that quick. I could see him down there. No legendaries. Sorry if I did that too quick. Hopefully you got the XP for that one. Oh, sorry. I'll re-invite.
A fair price.
Hopefully you're in the game this time. There you go, I see level up. Beastmaster skin. I want to do YouTube, but I don't know how. Do you have a PC? Like a pretty decent PC? You don't need a really, really good one. You just need a one that can handle you being able to make videos. Like my other computer's a 3.2 gigahertz processor. I did have to upgrade all the memory, so it's up to 16 gigs of RAM. And it's a super old computer. It's a low-profile computer. That's why I had to get a new one, was because I needed a better graphics card, because I only could put a low-profile graphics card in, and it's not good enough. But yeah, that's basically how you start. And so either a laptop or a computer. And so I basically started making videos with my track team. And so I would always record my track players, my track runners, because I'm the sprints coach, the jumps coach. Well, I started off with as a jumps coach. And so I would always record all my jumpers and then go over with them after each meet and each practice of form and technique. And I would always post it onto YouTube, so I have like 7 years of YouTube videos for my kids. And so that's basically where I learned how to do minor editing, and I've had Adobe Premiere Pro for the longest time now, and it's like $20 a month, which is kind of expensive, but I guess it's worth it if you start making money off of YouTube, because that's really pocket change. And then, like just recently in January, I decided that I wanted to start making gaming videos, and I've actually wanted to make gaming videos for a while. But like, I never really had the setup and never really knew exactly what I needed. And that's when I ended up getting this cheap PC. And it was like $200 for it. Oh, I already own that one. And yeah, the PC was only $200, and then to upgrade everything to make it a decent computer was probably like another $200. But you can get like a good $600 PC on Amazon, and that's originally the PC that I was gonna get, was this $600 one. And I still might get it to have a dual streaming setup, so I can have a good PC to run my games, and then a streaming PC just to handle the streams. Because right now, I mean, I am going through my Xbox, which goes through my capture card. And so it's using up processing, but I mean, my computer's really, really good. But I don't know how it would do if I were to be playing Borderlands on the PC. But the basic thing is just to, so if I don't have a PC, do you know how to record? Well, the biggest thing is to be able to edit your videos, because you just don't want to have, you know, recorded gameplay and not have be a way to, you know, have an introduction and be able to edit out your flaws in the video and to make it how you want it. Because, I mean, it's good to get started to just make videos, but as I was making, like, Disneyland Adventures, I really wish I would have had a better setup and more of a knowledge that I know now for my first episodes, because, like, my first, like, 15 episodes are, like, my most popular, and, like, the very first one sucked. And did I get ammo? And, like, I really wish that I would have made a good quality video for my first one, because then I think I would have got more views, more subscribers from it. And so, yeah, there's, I mean, a bunch of stuff you need. I mean, you could just, like, just start posting videos, like I said. But you really want to have, like, a good mic and a good mic setup. Because you don't want to have crappy audio. You don't want to have headset audio for your gameplay. Because then people aren't going to watch. They're going to watch something that looks really, really good. Or have really, really good sound. I mean, you could have, like, the best information, but if it's crappy audio and crappy visuals, then they're just going to skip it and not want to watch. But you can get a Elgato capture card, and then you plug that. You plug your gameplay to the capture card so you can record it. But then again, I don't know how to be able to put it on to YouTube from that point. Like, you can do the Xbox gameplay, and I guess you can record on the Xbox. You just have to get probably a hard drive here and hook it up through the Xbox. And then again, I don't know how you'd be able to, without a computer, to be able to get the gameplay from the recorded device to YouTube. But the best thing probably to do is just to do live streams if you want to start live streaming. But again, I think it's kind of hard to live stream without a background. And especially, like, all the videos that I watch a lot of Alpha Gaming, and he's part of, like, Twitch, and he's a pretty big person on Twitch, and he does YouTube videos of how to increase your Twitch views, and Twitch is supposedly really hard to be big on, because they really don't promote you. YouTube, if you make videos, I think YouTube works really well with YouTube Live. But again, I'm not trying to be a big streamer. I more wanna be better at making videos and having, like, 100% completions for games. Because I want to make how-to Borderlands videos. Yep. Yeah, I want to do more of the completion percentage of the game. So I want to show how chapter 1's completed all the way up to chapter 23, and then how to do all each and every side mission, and where all the claptraps are, and where the iridium stones, and just basically everything, crew challenges. Even though it's on the map, I mean, somebody here might not have Borderlands 3 and they just like to watch the gameplay and they want to see everything. Like I watch Grand Theft Auto. I have played Grand Theft Auto 5, but I haven't played on the PC, but I really like watching Bay Area Bugs and watching his gameplay of what is that called? The roleplay. Oh, I'm gonna die. But yeah, so I like watching like all the different scenarios he goes through. Him, Polecat, and Jeff Fagorino. And it's not like a game that I play, but it's interesting to, you know, watch them do their quest and do their challenges, do their stories. And that's something that I want to do with me and my partner. Damn, again. Reload quick. Kill him. This is why you're a good YouTuber. Oh, thanks. I know I need more content. That's my biggest problem, because I'm still really, really new. And so once when I get more content, I think I can increase. But I'm happy with the way that it's progressing. Like, I'm okay with having a subscriber every single day subscribe. And that's probably what I'm averaging right now. This summer I worked really hard on producing a lot of videos and getting videos out. And I think like with just this live stream, I mean, I'm not doing the live stream to make money. I'm doing the live stream to, you know, interact with you guys. Like, I enjoy playing the game with you, Bizarre. And same thing with Spiders. I like playing the game with other people. And it's fun. And then I get a chat along with like all my athletes and get to meet some new people. And hopefully, you know, I want to build like a community here of, I mean, I don't want to have like the chat go all crazy. Like, I wouldn't be able to handle like how some of those Twitch users, like, it's just like constantly streaming. It's like, how do you see everybody that's happening here? And I'm okay with just like looking over and then reading a couple here and then going back, checking, and there's still no comments. Oh, get out of here. But yeah, once, like, if it gets like huge and just like everybody's chatting and trying to talk to me, I'll probably get stressed out. But I mean, I'm really liking the live stream. It's fun. It's fun to hang out, like I said, and show you guys like my gameplay, show you guys like what I do, just to have fun, rather than just being a serious video and, you know, this is where you go to defeat Graveward, this is how, what kind of gun you want to use, and let's see how fast we can beat him in. I need faster reload. But yeah, I don't want to discourage you of making YouTube videos. But you should look into getting a computer. And if you can get a computer, that's basically what you need to start. And then just start building your stuff up one at a time. And I mean, that's basically how I built up my system. As I started off with just the Xbox and the basic computer and just even a basic mic. My mic sucked before. It was like a $15 Amazon mic. And I thought the sound sounded good, but now this mic here, this is a Rode mic. Oh, it sounds so beautiful. And then I also have a mixer too to help with the sound. So, oh, I went back. Wrong one. To help with the sound quality, so I don't have to. I mean, I still go through Audacity, which is the sound recording program for my YouTube videos, but I really don't have to make any adjustments to the sound, because I mean, if I wanted to lower the bass in my voice, I can lower it down, and that was just all with the mixer. But again, this mic's the shit. It is kind of expensive. But talking to my friend who's a country singer, he said that this is the mic that they use. And so, which got me away from getting the Blue Yeti or what's the other good one? The Snowball. And then, like, I hear from just reading the Amazon comments, like, a lot of people say it's good, and a lot of people say that it's not a lot, but some people say it's bad, that, like, the Yeti and the Snowball, like, have this, like, humming sound on them. And so, I don't know. My friend has a YouTube channel, but it is bad. See, and that's where, I mean, yeah, you can start making videos and stuff, but like, you want to, like, be impressive and sound professional. And I think that's the first thing that, I mean, I had a piece of shit mic. And then once when I found out that was a piece of shit, within, like, 15 episodes, I ended up getting a new mic when I can afford it. And that's all you got to do is just build up your system a little at a time. So, of course, got to get your PC, go get a cheap mic. You have to get a... Oh, three times a month, that's no good. If you're a video game player, you gotta post every day. And if not more. Another guy that I watch is T. Martin. He posts like 3-4 videos every day. And that's just on gaming. That's not including his other three channels he has. It's just, if you want to be popular and you want to get the YouTube algorithm to be on your side, you gotta post all the time. At least on the daily. They say once a week, you're not gonna get any type of visibility once a week. You gotta have at least a video out a day. And so my goal for 2019 when I started this was to have 365 total videos. Trying to find you.
Losing you today. Good as new.
But yeah, it's to have the 365 videos. One video every single day of the year, and I know I'm close to it. My first, I want to say February was a pretty good month, but then I got super busy with track. And I really wasn't able to keep up on videos as often. The redundant butcher. Do I have this? I still haven't seen the stupid earwig. All right, let's restart. And I know I'm saying the name wrong. It's not earwig. Earworm. What is my favorite gun? It's this machine gun that I have. I just got it last night playing against Graveward. The Butcher. I gotta try out the Butcher. Let me send you an invite first, and then I will show you. I just like it because it's got tons of ammo at a big old magazine size. I want to say this is it. Yeah, the Engulfing Ferrocaser. 66 magazine size, and I could just hold down the button. I didn't know that it had a shotgun to it. But I am kind of liking this sniper rifle that you gave me. You might not get it back. Just kidding. I'm okay with it now that it's not ricocheting and giving me one-shot deaths. Because that was really pissing me off. Hopefully you're in here. Come on, be quick, be quick.
Step to the wrong chick.
The Mind Melt White Elephant. This is fun. I like doing this better than the struggling and keep dying. I like the Butcher because it fits my playstyle. Is the Butcher a shotgun? It's like I said, I wanna say I have it. I do have my favorite gun from Borderlands 2. That is the conference call. That was supposedly like the best gun in the game. And it's not this one here. I have another conference call someplace. And hopefully I didn't sell it. Yeah, this is it right here.
I'm here now.
But yeah, this one, I like how all the guns go every which way and go sideways.
Now get out of here.
All right, let me reset my camera. What level have you gotten up to? Oh, you have 3 Ludas for me? Do you have the fire one? Because I went to go check. I have the corrosion. The Brazilian Resolute. But this one's kind of garbage. Your controller died. I hate when that happens. Sorry, I got this guy. We'll level you up. Quick style. Don't fall off! I'm gonna die quick style. So on the bottom bazaar, where it's right below the spin guardian tokens, where it's all purple, I know level 50 is the max. If it fills up, do you get more guardian tokens? Is that what happens? Or what happens when you fill up? Already owned. So where the XP fills up on the bottom, it's purple now. What happens when you fill it up? Like, I'm close to filling it up. I'll be able to see. Do you get more guardian tokens? Is that what happens every time you fill up the purple gauge? So, okay, I can't point over there. Right down there. We're right above the level 50. Do you see how my gauge is almost full? Do you get these guardian tokens? Because I'm trying to figure out how to get these. I know from other Borderlands, you have to just kill guys, and there's certain rankings to get each guardian token, but I really don't see any list anywhere. You can have infinite guardian tokens. That's good. That's what I need. Hopefully 100% on everything. Oh, I forgot to send the invite. Sorry. And my friend's supposed to jump on, but I'm not sure when. But yeah, I'm just trying to figure out how the guardian tokens work. I'm falling off. Oh, I just barely saved myself. Come on, reload fast, reload fast. I guess so, because I just got more guardian tokens there. The epicenter. It burns, burns, burns. I do need to change my thumbnail for this game because it started off as the pain and terror. Then I need to go to Graveward and get a good picture of him. $1.8 million. I need to go spend that money before I start dying. Does it take out so much for each death? I think it's like 10%. Sign. Run.
I'm good. I'm getting there.
No, I don't think the story in this one's as good. I like the story. I thought it was pretty decent.
Okay, no,
I liked how it turned out being the first Vault Hunters kids that did it. And then again, I like the constant action in the game. Like, we're always in a fight. Except for when you're on Mayhem 3, and then the badasses, there's like three badasses with bazooka launchers at you, and then there's unlimited firing at you, and it's like, pow, 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 pow. No way you can get into a room. I think this was set up for the fourth one, yes. I was watching some videos about the Guardians, and it was pretty interesting. I've been sending invites the whole gameplay, and I cannot remember how to send an invite. But yeah, supposedly there's a seventh siren that you don't want to... that's not supposed... or that's hidden. And you don't want to wake that seventh siren for some reason. As it's probably the ender of the worlds. That's the one thing I got out of that video. My ammo on his eye because his eye doesn't do anything. 2, 3.
Oh, get in there.
What level are you, Bizarre? Ruby's Wrath. Still no earworm. Level 32. Alright, so my friend's probably going to come on in a half an hour. If you want to... play together in like half an hour. I kind of got to take a break. Sounds good. Oh, you want your gun back?
Show me what you got.
Let's find your gun. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and reset, get everything sold that I don't want. So we can go through another grinding session of Graveward. Alright, so it's fine. Just hook me up later on the next stream. So I'll message you when I get back on, and then we can grind together with the Orion's Hand. All right, guys, so thanks again for watching this live stream here of Borderlands 3. I know I did go off topic of playing Pain and Terror. We were searching for that earworm for this guy here, but he wasn't dropping no earworm. But, I mean, we were getting like 2-3 legendaries almost every time. And we're only on Mayhem 1, and it's really melting. And then I know Bizarre leveled up a few levels there, probably 4 or 5 levels, which is great. So Bizarre, was always fun playing with you. I'll see you in probably about 30 minutes when my partner texts me. Dylan, it was nice to see you on the stream. Sorry if I missed your content or your comment, but it was good to see you, Grant. As always, been fun. And that looks like all the comments. I don't know how to emote on the stream. I don't think we can for YouTube Live. I still haven't figured that out. I know Twitch has emotes there, but I'm not a Twitch person. I'm more of a YouTube person. I want to build up the YouTube channel. That's why I'm on YouTube Live. All right, so we'll see you in about 30 minutes' time when Orion's Hand gets on. Thanks again for joining us on this stream, and I'll see you on the next video.